dedicated to fashioning the greatest warriors of the Bonereaper hosts, Mortisan Ossifectors can be found at work even in the midst of battle. And in this video, we'll be showing you how to paint the Mortisan Ossifector just using 7 paints, getting him painted quickly so he can start his bone-weaving magic for the great Lord Nagash. You'll notice that we haven't fully assembled this miniature. This is because it's much easier to paint it in this way. We could put it all together fully at the end. The first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the sub-assemblies, and for this we've chosen to use Wraithbone and Grey Seer. These will be great starting points for both of these. You'll also need a pot of Wraithbone and Grey Seer to hand. This will help us tidy up any mistakes we might make later on. All the paints you need to follow along in this guide are listed on the screen right now. You'll also need some contrast medium for thinning some of these paints. If you are new to painting or want to know more about the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos. First, we'll apply Skeleton Horde to all of the bone on both sub-assemblies. We want to make sure that we get enough on our brush so it flows into the recesses and colours evenly all over. You don't have to worry about being super neat at this stage, as we'll be dry brushing over the model next. You'll also notice that we're applying this over Wraithbone and Grey Seer undercoats, and we'll have slightly different tones when dry, making the magical bone stand out from the rest of his body. Next, we'll dry brush over the bone with Terminatus Stone. We want to work in circular motions to get all of those raised areas covered from all angles. Just be careful when dry brushing the bone emanating from the magical energy, as you can pop your finger behind it to steady it so it doesn't bend or break. You can either remove the moisture from the paint with a paper towel or the back of your palette on the cardboard. If you don't have any Terminatus Stone, you can use Screaming Skull if you have that paint already. With that dry brush finished, we'll move on to making some of the bones darker with Saigor Brown. We'll take one part Saigor Brown and three parts Contrast Medium to make a slightly thinner consistency. You can use water instead, but the medium gives us a much smoother finish when dry. We'll add a smaller amount to the fingers, and as it moves and dries, it will give a soft blend to the skeleton horde underneath, and those dry brushing highlights will still pop through as well. Next, we'll use Flesh Terror's Red for the cloth, making sure that we get all around those bony details and apply enough to get that vivid finish we want. If you do get any of the red onto the bones, don't worry, we can just tidy up with a little bit of Wraithbone, then reapply Skeleton Horde afterwards. Now we'll move on to the blue details, and we'll be using Cantor Blue for these. We want to focus on the plate armour around the chest and the legs, and that small gemstone in the bone chain around his waist. As these details are small, we'll be using our small layer brush for these and use a couple of thinner coats to build up the colour. Cantor Blue is a rich, dark blue tone, but if you want to go even darker, you can use Night Lord's Blue as well. With the armour now dry, we'll apply Grey Seer to the pale bone details. These can be found around the blue armour plates. These are small details surrounded by lots of other colours, so take your time and use the smallest brush you have. You can also use this colour to tidy up any patches of colour on the magical energy, so it's ready for a paint later on. Next, we'll use Nuln Oil to shade the pale bone, blue armour and the red cloth. We want to make sure that we don't overload the areas with this paint, so a small layer brush and small amounts of shade will avoid this issue. But if you do find it's pooling in places, just clean off your brush and soak it away. And to finish off, we'll use Hexwraith Flame in two ways. We'll start by painting the glowing eyes with the paint straight out of the pot, using our small layer brush as it's going to give us enough paint on the brush, but still small enough to get into those sockets. Then we'll take one part Hexwraith Flame and two parts Contrast Medium or water and apply it to the magical energy on the base. Take your time around the bone and keep an eye on it as it dries. If you want, you can add a second coat in the recesses for a darker effect. Now your Mortisan Ossifector is ready to head into the battlefield and make the Ossiarch Bonereapers even more terrifying against their enemies. You can see that our model is based in astrogranite debris, and if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, you can check out our video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and techniques, head to citadelcolour.com. Or you can also head to a Warhammer store where our friendly staff will help you out. Well, we hope you enjoyed this painting video and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!